I'm Worm Guy Harry, and I believe that everyone needs a worm farm at home. Today, we're gonna be setting up a quick and easy beginner worm farm in 4 easy steps. Plus, stick around for the bonus tip. Most beginners start in the wrong order. This simple 4-step guide gets your bin ready before your worms even arrive. Let's start with step 1, and no, it's not anything to do with worms. It's actually picking your bin. We can break this down into big spaces, medium spaces, small spaces, inside, outside. It goes on and on. I actually made a video about that that I'll link below. But here's the thing. Remember, this hobby is about preventing waste. So you could go and buy a really fancy worm farm, which I totally support. But you could also do this for very cheap, if not free. The bin that we're using today here, I found under my bed. If your bin's gonna be inside and require a lid, make sure you drill holes around your bin to prep it. Bigger bins are gonna mean more castings, but don't let small bins discourage you. They're okay too. Step 2, and again, not worms, but hey, they're coming. We need to prepare the bedding. This might be one of the most important parts. You can use a lot of materials, and you can even buy a ready-made pack for you. Paper, cardboard, coconut core, peat moss, these are all options that you can use and you can find online. I like paper and cardboard. How many things do you order from Amazon a week? Generally, that is free. You're gonna cut it or tear it into small pieces. I have a cross-cut shredder. I really like mine. You can use that, but you don't need it. The bigger the pieces, the more time it'll just take to break down. You're gonna soak this in unchlorinated water. Squeeze it. You're looking for about 1 drop of water and it feeling like a damp sponge. When you open your hand, you don't want it soaking. You just want it to stay together until you give it a shake and then it'll break apart. You're only looking to make about 4 to 6 inches of bedding for your bin. You can get really complicated with this, with exact ratios and all that kind of stuff. And that's gonna get more important when we start feeding, but the bedding itself, use what you have. Make sure you keep out any tapes or plastics. Those are gonna be really harsh on your worms and almost impossible to break down. Pro tip, moisture is the number one thing that beginners get wrong, other than adding the worms too early. But if it's too wet, it goes anaerobic, meaning there's microbes in there you don't want, and there's no oxygen in that part of your compost or bedding. Too dry, that's gonna stress the worms and they're not gonna be able to breathe. Worms breathe through their skin and they need moisture to do that. So keep your bedding wet, even till your worms arrive. But remember, wet doesn't mean soaking. All right. Step 3, hey, we're almost there, and guess what? It's almost time to get those wormies. Step 3 is super important, and it's all about building biology first. Your bedding isn't just shredded cardboard, maybe some coconut core. It needs to be alive. Not like a Frankenstein movie or anything like that, but it really does need to become alive. Here's 2 separate done beddings. They look the same. They are totally different. One is alive, one is not. Well, it's what we can't see that matters. Worms eat the microbiology. So let's create some. If you have some finished worm castings or compost, throw that in. That's a really easy way to get it started. But a lot of us, especially if we're beginners, don't have access to that kind of stuff. So don't go out and spend money. Take a banana, after you've eaten it, sit the peel out for a couple days on the counter or in your little compost jar. You could even freeze it and then thaw it. That helps it break down quicker. But it doesn't really matter. Just cut it up into little pieces. The more surface area on it, just like on the cardboard, the better, the more space for that microbiology to attach to it. We're gonna bury that a few inches deep into our bedding. We're gonna cover the banana. We're gonna make sure that bedding is covered with some kind of material. That could be a trash bag. That could be bubble wrap like we're using today, newspaper. It really doesn't matter as long as it keeps moisture in. And then we're gonna let it sit for 1 to 2 weeks. Step four, ordering the worms, baby. Here we go. So step four, we're finally ordering the worms. While that bin sits, you wanna order red wigglers, also known as Encenia fetida. Red wigglers, all right? And you'll need about 1 pound per square foot of surface area. Depth does not matter. People think the deeper the bin, the more worms I could have. Not the case. It just means you're gonna be able to collect more worm castings and maybe have more room to work with. You could see our bin is not very deep. 1,000 worms or about 1 pound per square foot, give or take 200 each way. Worms will reproduce and expand their colony if the conditions are right. Let me tell you a little bit about shipping while you're waiting on your worms. I recommend who to order worms from below. They will ship early in the week during milder months, and I would ask the post office to hold it for you if possible so they don't sit inside your mailbox. Also, the breeder is gonna send you instructions via email. Read them. They know their stock better than anybody else, and they're gonna make sure that you're set up for success. And now we're here, but before we go, I wanna give you one bonus tip. Your worms have arrived. You gently place them into your bedding that's still damp. Don't feed them right away. The biggest mistake possible for beginners or even experienced worm farmers is feeding too much or too quickly. Remember, your bedding is alive. They'll eat that bedding and turn it into a high quality worm casting. After a few days, your worms have become accustomed to their new home. Start with small feedings of fruit and vegetable scraps. Bury it. Don't feed again until they've finished everything that they started with. This should be simple and fun. Below you'll find links and a free done-for-you guide that shows you every step we've talked about today. Remember, good things come from dirty work. I'm Worm Guy Harry, and I'll see you in the next one.